topic is cerebrospinal fluid. It is also called as CSF. Popular name is CSF, means cerebrospinal fluid. Definition or introduction? First we will see the definition. What is CSF? CSF kya hota hai? CSF, it is a modified tissue fluid. जैसा कि अपने बॉडी में लिम्फ भी होता है, लिम्फ इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मॉडिफाइड टिश्यू फ्लूइड. सो सीएसएफ इज लाइक लिम्फ, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इज अ मॉडिफाइड टिश्यू फ्लूइड. इट इज अ कलरलेस, ओडरलेस एंड वाटरी और ट्रांसपेरेंट फ्लूइड. सो इट इज अ कलरलेस, ओडरलेस, वाटरी और ट्रांसपेरेंट फ्लूइड. लाइज इन द वेंट्रिकुलर सिस्टम ऑफ ब्रेन and subarachnoid space around the brain and spinal cord. As we had seen the ventricular system of brain in the previous video, so this cerebrospinal fluid, it is a modified tissue fluid. It is a colorless, odorless, watery or transparent fluid, lies in the ventricular system of brain and in subarachnoid space around the brain and spinal cord. So, ventricular system of brain, in earlier video we had seen there are two lateral ventricles, a third ventricle and a fourth ventricle. So, in this ventricular cavity, this fluid lies, that is called as cerebrospinal fluid. Now, we will see the subarachnoid space. We had seen what is the ventricular system. Now, we will see what is the subarachnoid space. We know the meninges. These meninges are the covering of brain. Meninges are the covering of brain, and these meninges, they are described as PAD. The mnemonic is PAD. P for pia matter. A for arachnoid matter. And D for dura mater. So, PAD means the most inner layer is the pia mater. Then outer to pia mater is the arachnoid mater, and outer to arachnoid mater is the dura mater. So, meninges, which is the covering of brain, it is having three layers from inner to outer. That is P for pia mater, A for arachnoid mater, and D for dura mater. So this subarachnoid space that lies below the arachnoid mater. So the most inner layer is the pia mater. So space in between the pia mater and the arachnoid mater is called as subarachnoid space. So this lies in the ventricular system and the subarachnoid space, which lies around the brain and spinal cord. This subarachnoid space, it lies around the brain as well as the spinal cord. So this is about the definition or introduction of cerebrospinal fluid. Now the second thing, how it is formed? Kaise banta hai? This cerebrospinal fluid, it is formed with the help of choroid plexus. The choroid plexus, as we had seen, these choroid plexus, they lies in the ventricular system of brain. So the choroid plexus of third ventricle and the choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle. So there are choroid plexus lies in each ventricles, means two lateral ventricle. The major part of this CSF is formed by the choroid plexus, which lies in the lateral ventricle of the brain, and the minor part is added by the choroid plexus of the third and fourth ventricle. So choroid plexus that form the CSF, major part of the CSF is formed by the choroid plexus of the lateral ventricle, which lies in the central part and the inferior horn of the lateral ventricle, and a part is added by the choroid plexus of third ventricle, which lies in the roof of the third ventricle, and a part again added by the choroid plexus of fourth ventricle, which lies in the roof of the fourth ventricle. So choroid plexus that forms the CSF. Secondly, the capillaries which lies around the surface of brain and spinal cord also forms the CSF. So CSF is majorly formed by the choroid plexus. In the choroid plexus, the choroid plexus of lateral ventricle forms a major quantity, and the quantity is added by the choroid plexus of third and fourth ventricle also. And the capillaries which lie on the surface of brain and spinal cord, that will also add the CSF. Now we will see the circulation of cerebrospinal fluid or CSF. How the CSF is circulated? We had seen definition and formation of CSF. So after formation, how it is circulated? This CSF, as I had told you, it is formed by the choroid plexus. So major part of the choroid plexus of lateral ventricle which forms the CSF. So from the lateral ventricle, the CSF which goes into the third ventricle. So from each lateral ventricle, the CSF goes to third ventricle through interventricular foramina. The interventricular foramina or foramina of Monro. So this is the interventricular, this arrow shows the interventricular foramina. So from each lateral ventricle, these are the two lateral ventricles, right and left lateral ventricle. So after from the lateral ventricle, it passes to the third ventricle through the interventricular foramina or foramina of Monro. Then in the from the third ventricle through the cerebral aqueduct. This CM is cerebral aqueduct. So from the third ventricle, it passes through the cerebral aqueduct up to the fourth ventricle. First, it passes from the lateral ventricle to the third ventricle through the interventricular foramina or foramina of Monro. This arrow shows foramina of Monro. Then from the third ventricle, it goes to the fourth ventricle through the cerebral aqueduct. This is the cerebral aqueduct. This small channel is called as cerebral aqueduct. And from the fourth ventricle, it goes further into the central canal. See, this is the central canal. This one is the central canal. So from fourth ventricle, it goes to the central. Now from the central canal, it goes from the central canal to the. So from the fourth ventricle, it goes into the central canal and subarachnoid space. So from here, fourth ventricle, it goes into the central canal and subarachnoid space. This arrow shows the median aperture. We had seen there in the fourth ventricle, there are three apertures, a median aperture and two lateral aperture. So this is the median aperture. This median aperture, it is called as the foramina of Magendie. I had told you how to remember the foramina Magendie. It is a median aperture, so M for median, M for Magendie. And two lateral aperture, which is not shown in this figure, because this is the lateral view. So two lateral aperture, they are called as foramina of Luschka. So through these three foramens, these CSF that goes into the subarachnoid space. So it passes from the three foramina, means the median aperture or median foramina and the two lateral aperture or two lateral foramina. The median foramina is called as foramina Magendie and two lateral foramina is called as the foramina Luschka. So these three through these three foramina, it passes into the subarachnoid space. So this space is the subarachnoid space. See, where my pen is rotating, that space is called as subarachnoid space. So this is the subarachnoid space. See, this space is subarachnoid space. Now from the subarachnoid space, these CSF that get reabsorbed. Now after circulation, we will see the absorption, how the CSF is absorbed, because it is a continuous process. Formation and the absorption is the continuous process. So CSF is absorbed with the help of arachnoid villi and the granulation. So arachnoid villi and granulation, they are nothing but the projection of the arachnoid matter into the dura mater. So we have seen the coverings of brain. Coverings of brain are, as I had told you, फ्रॉम इनर टू आउटर द निमोनिक इज पैड, पी फॉर पाया मैटर, ए फॉर अरेक्नॉइड मैटर, डी फॉर ड्यूरा मैटर. सो द CSF which lies in the subarachnoid space, the space between the pia mater and the arachnoid mater is called as subarachnoid space. So this subarachnoid, this arachnoid villi which extend in the layer of dura mater, that's why it is also called as the CSF drained into the cranial or the dural venous sinus. So the it is absorbed with the help of arachnoid villi and granulation. So arachnoid villi are nothing but the extension of the subarachnoid space into the dural space. So dura mater, it ultimately the venous sinus lies in the dura mater, in between the two layer, the outer layer and the inner layer. So outer layer is the periosteal layer of dura mater, and the inner layer is the meningeal layer. Inner layer of the dura mater is meningeal layer. So in between these two layer, the dural venous sinus lies. So the CSF is absorbed in the arachnoid villi and the granulation. The arachnoid villi together they are called as the arachnoid granulation. So major part of the CSF is absorbed by the arachnoid villi and the granulation, and they are drained ultimately into the cranial or the dural venous sinus. This dural venous sinus is lies in between the two layer of dura mater, like the periosteal layer and the meningeal layer of the dura mater. And another, the veins which are related to the spinal nerve, that also absorb the CSF. So CSF is absorbed by arachnoid villi and granulation, and the veins which is related to the spinal nerves. Now we will see how many quantity of CSF lies, the total quantity of CSF. So total quantity, the total quantity of CSF lies at a time is 150 ml. Total quantity of CSF lies at a time is 150 ml, and it is secreted at the rate of 25 ml per hour. 25 ml per hour means 25 ml per hour means in 24 hours. How much it is to be secreted? So total quantity of the CSF secreted in a day is about 600 ml, which is secreted at the rate of 25 ml hour. But the total quantity lies at a time is 150 ml. So the process of formation of CSF and the absorption of CSF, that is continuous. That's why we have to know the formation and absorption. So it is a continuous process. That's why the total quantity is produced is about 600 ml per day, while as at a time only 150 ml lies. Then we will see the functions. What are the functions of CSF? What does it CSF functions? So the main function of CSF is to protective function. So it gives protection. Protection to whom? Brain, definitely, because it lies in the cavity of the brain. So it gives protection to the brain from the any trauma, from any trauma or injury. So it provides protection to the brain from any trauma or injury. How? By the cushion type work, a cushion like work. It used because it is having a, the CSF is a, lies in the ventricular cavity, and whole the brain is suspended in the CSF. So it gives a cushion like support to the brain and prevent it from the trauma and injury. The second important function is the nutritive function. Second important function is the nutritive. The CSF provides nutrition to the brain. Brain ko jitne bhi nutrients milte hai, wo hota hai CSF se. So the it is having a nutritive function. The next function is the it अलाउज द पाथवे, इट अलाउज द पाथवे फॉर मेटाबोलाइट्स, इट अलाउज द पाथवे फॉर द मेटाबोलाइट्स फ्रॉम सीएनएस सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम, मीन्स ऑल द मेटाबोलाइज दे आर पास थ्रू द सीएनएस, और मेटा इट अलाउज द पाथवे फॉर द मेटाबोलाइट्स फ्रॉम द सीएनएस, मीन्स ऑल द मेटाबोलाइट्स फ्रॉम द सीएनएस इज पासिंग थ्रू विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सेरेब्रो स्पाइनल फ्लूइड. सो दीज आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ सेरेब्रो स्पाइनल फ्लूइड. नाउ वी विल सी द अप्लाइड पार्ट. व्हाट इज द अप्लाइड पार्ट ऑफ द दिस सेरेब्रो स्पाइनल फ्लूइड? अप्लाइड एनाटॉमी, अप्लाइड एनाटॉमी और क्लिनिकल एनाटॉमी, और क्लिनिकल एनाटॉमी. फर्स्ट वन, वी कैन एबल टू टेक अ सैंपल ऑफ सीएसएफ विद द हेल्प ऑफ लंबर पंक्चर. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, लंबर पंक्चर. सो लंबर पंक्चर, व्हाट इज लंबर पंक्चर? इट इज अ प्रोसीजर इन विच वी आर टेकिंग अ सैंपल ऑफ सीएसएफ. सो लंबर पंक्चर जनरली डन फ्रॉम द इन बिटवीन द L3 एंड L4 और L4 एंड L5 वर्टिब्रा. सो लंबर पंक्चर इट इज अ प्रोसीजर थ्रू विच वी आर टेकिंग अ सैंपल ऑफ सेरेब्रो स्पाइनल फ्लूइड. वेयर फ्रॉम वेयर वी आर पासिंग द नीडल? वी आर पासिंग द नीडल इन बिटवीन द L3 एंड L4 वर्टिब्रा और L4 एंड L5 वर्टिब्रा. सो वी आर टेकिंग सैंपल एंड सेंडिंग इट टू द लैब. सो व्हाट इज द मेन रोल? सी द सेकंड अप्लाइड टॉमी, वी कैन एबल टू सी द बायोकेमिकल एनालिसिस. इन द लैब वी कैन एबल टू सेंड द सीएसएफ फॉर बायोकेमिकल एनालिसिस. दिस बायोकेमिकल एनालिसिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन केसेस फॉर सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम, फॉर द डिजीजेस ऑफ सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम. सो वी कैन एबल टू रूल आउट by the biochemical examination of CSF in case of disease of central nervous system. Various disease of the central nervous system is ruled out with the help of biochemical examination or biochemical analysis of the cerebral spinal fluid. Very important disease which is seen regularly, that is the meningitis. Meningitis, it is a inflammation of the covering of the brain is called as meningitis. In this we are giving a sample of this CSF from the lumbar puncture and sending it to the lab for the biochemical analysis to recognize the disease of central nervous system. For example, example is the meningitis. It is routinely done in case of meningitis. Now next one, the obstruction of CSF. As we had seen in the ventricles of brain, the obstruction of CSF that causes hydrocephalus. That causes hydrocephalus in children. So obstruction of CSF in children causes hydrocephalus, while as in adult it causes raised intracranial pressure. It causes raised intracranial pressure. So it is in the adults. The condition which is seen in the adults due to the obstruction of the cerebrospinal fluid is called as a raised intracranial pressure, which is seen in the adults. So obstruction that causes hydrocephalus in children and raised intracranial pressure in adult. So this is all about the cerebrospinal fluid. Thank you.